Hello, Taurus. It's Maria, insightfulastrology.com. Welcome to your October forecast. Taurus, huge emphasis on partnership for you, relationship, on secret endeavors, you know, behind the scenes stuff for you as well this month. So let's get started. I will begin by telling you that Mars, the planet of assertive drive, action, and energy, will move into your sixth house on the 4th and remains in your sixth house through November 19th. So what's the sixth house all about in your chart? It is your health, but it is also your work, your daily routine. Let's get the health stuff out of the way. When Mars is in the sixth house, if you have an existing health condition, it may aggravate it and you might need to address it. But you also will find that you have more energy to focus on your health, more motivation. And let's face it, Taurus, we can be lazy. We could neglect that area of our life sometimes. But now that Mars is stimulating this, it's kind of like, oh, maybe I should go to the gym. Maybe I should, give up gluten or whatever it is that you want to do. Okay, so I know for me, my daughter is, she keeps telling me, Mom, let's do that intermittent fasting. Let's, try that. And I did that at one point a couple of years ago, and it was actually, very helpful for a while. So I'm thinking about doing that. And it's funny because I'm sitting here telling you about your Taurus forecast, and that's actually something that I'm thinking of doing. But in any event, you're motivated to do something about your health. Very good. But now, Mars in your sixth house is also your work life, your daily routine. How you complete your tasks. You're in a frenzy this month, Taurus. It will not be a quiet month for you. It will be an insanely over-scheduled, over-committed month for you in terms of work. Fortunately, you'll be able to handle it. I would suggest that you take a big step back when it comes to people that you work with or people that you employ, and be careful about not engaging in any conflict if it's not absolutely necessary. Because Mars going through the sixth house can bring a little bit of contentious behavior, competition, jealousy between you and a colleague, or it can bring some issues with you and someone that you employ. So it's possible, but Mars here is always, okay, I gotta rush. I gotta meet this deadline. I'm running to this meeting. I have this appointment. I have this phone call. I have this event. It's a lot on your plate in the month of October. And you need to find a place of calm and center yourself, which you are good at doing, Taurus. You're usually very grounded and practical. And so I think that by the 13th, you're going to recognize, oh my God, I need a timeout. And that timeout comes at the full moon in your hidden 12th house. So a full moon in the 12th house is a retreat, kind of a full moon. It is I'm exhausted. I'm spent. I have nothing left to give. If I don't put my own oxygen mask on first, I have nothing to offer you. And it's that realization, Taurus, that you're going to have right around the 13th. So again, pay attention to your well-being and your health and make sure that you're doing something to recharge your own batteries, because if you don't, by the 13th, you're probably going to crash. It won't last too long, but it is showing up as potential for you because you're just so damn busy. There's a lot of change for you in career this month, and it requires you to be all over the place. Okay, Uranus is the ruler of your career sector, and Venus will move into your partnership sector on the 8th and immediately oppose Uranus in your sign on the 12th. So this is a sudden destabilization of a partnership or a sudden connection with a partner. Okay, it could go either way. It is exciting. It is sudden. It is collaborative. Venus in your seventh house is really an energy where you're motivated, your desire, your urge, your intention is to collaborate with somebody else. But the opposition to Uranus, the ruler of your career sector, is saying that this is going to be done in an unusual way, or perhaps it is an unusual partnership arrangement, non-traditional in some way, whatever it is that you're trying to achieve now in business. This could also have to do with your personal life, okay? Because the partnership sector is your relationship. And it's possible that if you're in a commitment, all of a sudden you're like, you know what? I need a break. I need a little bit of freedom. And your partner might also be the one who does this, but since Uranus is in your sign, I think it might be more about you just wanting to go out there and you're so busy and doing other things this month that it's hard for you to give your attention and focus to the partner as much as you would like. So at the same time, there is a motivation to relate. And Venus is your ruling planet. So wherever Venus is important to track. So Venus will remain in the seventh house of partnership, overall helping to add harmony to the relationship. The harmony isn't going to happen between the 8th and the 12th, however. That's instability. The harmony is going to happen between the 20th and the 25th, when Venus makes gorgeous aspects to Saturn, Neptune, and Pluto. That's when you're going to see, oh, I love this person. We're in a good relationship. This is a good fit, whether it's business or personal or both. And then on the 27th, there is a new moon in your partnership sector. So this could be when you are actually forging a legal relationship with somebody. This could be you, let's say you're dating someone, you decide to make it exclusive, you get engaged, you decide to move in together, get married, whatever the next level of commitment is for you. And again, this lunation is also opposite Uranus in your sign. So it's a sudden development, sudden change, okay? New moons are initiation, new beginning. So even though it's opposite Uranus, I'm inclined to tell you that it's more about a new partnership than a separative aspect. Although with Uranus in the mix, there is going to be something highly unusual about this relationship, about this commitment. And it is possible that you're building something on shaky ground. So can't really give you more details about that without looking at your particular horoscope. But because Uranus is so involved in both the new moon and the initial stage of Venus going into your seventh house, it's exciting but unsteady. There's something unsteady about this. So keep that in mind, because you don't like unsteady. You like predictable. Now, it could also be that you're partnering up with someone who is incredibly innovative. Uranus rules anything genius, anything ahead of its time, whether it's technology. Uranus rules astrology. Uranus rules all of the advanced sciences. So this person, you know, it might be an Albert Einstein type of moment or connection with this person, or you might be actually inventing something with a partner and collaborating on that. That would be a reflection of the Uranian energy, and it would certainly fit the new beginnings that I'm seeing for you as well. But just keep in mind that this is really exciting, but the game will change as you move forward because Uranus is involved. But I don't think that this is necessarily a negative relationship. I just think that there's a lot of excitement and impulsivity. And then you're going to take a step back by the end of the month and say, wait a second, what can I do to make this better? Maybe I wasn't clear about this thought or what I wanted here. Let's see how we can get on the same page together. And I say that to you because on the 31st, Mercury will go retrograde in your seventh house of partnership. And Mercury remains retrograde till November 20th. So for most of November, it's like you're going to jump off the airplane with this person and say, yay, let's go, let's do this. And then you're going to be like, holy shit, we don't have a parachute. And during the Mercury retrograde phase, you're going to build the parachute together, because Mercury's retrograde in your seventh house of partnership. So there is an element of connection here that you're fixing, that you're making better, that you're clarifying. You are clarifying your connections and your commitments in October, Taurus. Okay? So, thank you for watching, liking, sharing, and subscribing. Leave your comments below. Let me know what's going on in your reality. I always love to see how this fits with your story. And of course, if you would like my help during a personal consultation, all you need to do is click the link in the description box below, and we'll be talking very soon. Bye.